Insiders are selling at a rapid pace right now in 2019. Let's take a look.
There are an infinite amount of indicators. Most aren't very telling. Many become insignificant. With central banks completely ruining the markets permanently, it has become even more difficult to be able to determine what's valid or not. Central bank manipulation is the reason why there are so many problems today and that isn't being addressed. Today we have insiders selling at the fastest pace in the last decade. Nothing to worry about, right? You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. This is one very telling indicator. Some are better than others, and insiders selling should be that little tap on the shoulder to get you to pay attention. I previously had done a video about this back in September, showing you that insiders are selling at a record pace. And if I need to remind you what happened in October, November, and then December, this should be a warning. Now today, we have insiders selling at a record pace, the likes of which we haven't seen since the financial crisis. People don't want to wake up, but they don't realize what's happening, and that is very unfortunate. I will link to this video at the end of this video you're watching now if you want to check it out, what I documented back then in September if you hadn't seen it. I will be covering today a very important indicator that everybody should watch out for. Then I'm gonna tell you how to do this on your own. So let's get into it right away. The S&P 500 will be 3.9% lower in 12 months' time. That's the forecast out of the University of Michigan, their finance professor, and he has been around for a little while creating a model for this forecasting for Barron's. This is what this article talks about, and I think it's very important to watch this one indicator. In May of 2017, the model was bullish, and for obvious reasons. All throughout 2017, things were looking good. In fact, they were looking great in terms of the stock market. Everything was rising. You had basically global synchronous growth at that time. However, things had changed. As soon as the beginning of 2018 hit, right at the end of January, the problems really began. This stretches from Europe to China, and then following to the US. A problem started to come up in all different corners of the world. The ability of this model to predict the market has been found by peer-reviewed research to be highly statistically significant. When properly analyzed, the insider data does a better job predicting year-ahead returns than almost all of the better-known indicators that are popular on Wall Street. Personally, for me, I like to look at as many as I possibly can. If you're just gonna focus on one, no matter how good it is, it's never gonna give you the whole picture. But if we start to piece them all together, then we get a bigger insight into what's happening. But let's take this indicator today, and I'll show you what it's all about. Essentially, all of these insiders have to document all of their sales. It's through the SEC's Form 4, and that happens to be something that they can't get around. All of it is documented. That's why when you hear this executive sold, that executive sold, it's because the information is public, and there are ways to attain that information. When you look at this particular model, it's going to tell you who's selling and exactly when and how much they sold. If you start piecing that all together, it gives you the bigger picture of what's happening. If all the insiders are selling and only the average Joe is buying, that 7 share of Amazon type investors buying, then you have a problem. The key to the model is that only some of those who the law defines as insiders are worth following. We should pay attention to the buying and selling behavior of corporate officers and directors, as he has found from his research that they have genuine insight into their company's prospects. In contrast, we should overlook the transactions undertaken by the company's largest shareholders, since they do not on average possess this insight. So those are the shakers and the movers, the people who are actually doing the dirty deeds or that which needs to happen in order to make the deals, the mergers, all of the business that takes place. It's not necessarily done by the biggest and the company, those individuals there, they might be in the know. I'm not really denying that. However, the day-to-day business operations are not taken care of by these individuals. And that depends on each company, of course. They're all structured differently. But just in general, you go down a level or two or three or four sometimes, and you start to see the people who actually make a difference in that corporation. This distinction is important because the transactions undertaken by these larger shareholders typically dwarf those made by corporate officers and shareholders. So the analysis based on all insiders will be skewed by the behavior of those who have no insight into their company's prospects. So basically what he's saying is if the big guys are selling, it's going to look like so many of these insiders are really doing one thing. They're all going in one direction. Look at, for example, Zuckerberg. He sold a huge chunk of Facebook and it looked massive. It was billions of dollars. I'm not denying that. However, compared to the others, he was overwhelmingly the biggest shareholder that sold at that moment. And I covered that previously. But then you take it for what it is. All of the smaller guys, suddenly things start to look a little different. The bad news is that these indicators who historically have shown the most insight sold more of their company stock in the first half of February relative to their buying than they have in a decade. In about 5 of every 6 companies for which there have been recent insider transactions have experienced net selling. As far as I'm concerned, that's a huge indicator. Insiders are selling now, and not just a little bit, it's at a rate we haven't seen since the financial crisis. They're worried. At the same time, I'm sure, definitely, you have profit taking. They're looking at what happened throughout 2018. They're saying to themselves, this isn't 2017 anymore. I believe the time is now to cut some of those profits and take what we have. Let's cash it in. Let's move it over here into money markets. Let's keep it in cash. Let's do away with that risk taking, and maybe they're buying even into fixed income. It doesn't really give us that picture, but we at least know the fact that they are selling right now. Of course, he remains very bullish, saying don't worry about it whatsoever. Everything's going to be just fine. Although, if you look back in 2007, this model looked bullish as well. So, most people, even if they are on the inside, don't really understand how quickly things can unravel. Imagine that. 2007. Already the market started to look quite bad. You had many sectors starting to fall. The end of 2007 is pretty much the end of that bull market. 2008 was a disaster. And then, of course, that led into the first 3 months of 2009. Things looked very rocky. And then we had the bull market that came after. I just wanted to show you this to document what we had back in 2007 with this model, showing us that in fact, yes, they were selling, but they weren't worried. That's usually the way that I see it, okay? They are not able to foresee a crisis, but they know when is the right time to take some profits, and that's happening right now. So I'm not necessarily suggesting that they know exactly the day that the market is gonna crash, and so they're selling all their shares. Most of these people don't sell all their shares before a stock market crash, but they certainly will sell a percentage of them. They know that it's time to put it away into cash. You are at the end of the cycle. These people know what's going on, and it really is telling to see insiders selling at the pace that we have so far. I believe that it is important to track this information on a regular basis, not just with the 13 Fs of all these companies to see what they're buying, to see what they're interested in, but also the Form 4. And that Form 4 tells us what is going on at the inside of that company with respect to the insiders. They're selling shares right now. I believe that you should be tracking what is going on if you want to know exactly how to look up the Form 4 for yourself. Go to the end of this video and I'm gonna link to the video that I did, which you can see exactly that. In that video, I'm going to give you quick insight into exactly how to look this data up yourself. You'll be able to see the corporate insider activity on companies like Apple, for instance. You'll see the buys, you'll see the sells, you'll see who is doing it exactly on insider tracking. You're going to be able to look that up. Also, you could see everything that you need to know on every level. This is really just a few resources I'm going to show you to break that all down and make it easier for you to know what's going on, empowering you, as they say, teach a man to fish. If you found this video informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a thumbs up, you are supporting this channel, so I do appreciate that very much. You don't get other channels out there that actually tell you how to look into this yourself. Sometimes I feel that the media, whether it's the alternative or the mainstream, they want to keep you ignorant. Whereas for myself, I'm trying to basically break it down as simply as it possibly can be, give you every single resource that you need to be able to track this data on a regular basis. And then it's up to you. You can decide what you want to do with it. If you do appreciate that, hit the like button. You know, many people, they watch these videos, they like these videos, but they do not hit that like button. It's very easy. If you just hit a like button, hit the comments too. That is very, very appreciative, I assure you. If you want the financial education that was not taught to you in school, these two books have everything that you need. You can get everything from the foundation, the history, the asset classes, all about what you need to get out of debt, to make some money. So check them out at the link in the description if you want the audiobook that's available at themoneygps.com. If you want to find out what the insiders of these major corporations like Apple are up to, click on this video and you will be able to find out exactly that. See you there.